Welcome back! My name is Baller Scuba. This is Video Games Over Time. We are still in 1984. Today, we're going to talk about the arcade game 1942. The story of 1942 takes us to a Japanese company named Capcom. The predecessor to Capcom, IRM Corporation, was founded on May 30th, 1979 by Kenzo Sugimoto. At the time, Sugimoto was still president of IRM, which we talked about in our video on Kung Fu Master. IRM Corporation and its subsidiary, Japan Capsule Computers Company Limited, started by manufacturing and distributing electronic game machines. In September 1981, the two companies merged to become Sanbi Company Limited. On June 11, 1983, Sugimoto established Capcom Company Limited to take over the internal sales department of Sanbi Company. The name is a clipped compound of Capsule Computers. Capcom's first full arcade game would be Vulgus, which was released in May 1984. This was closely followed by 1942. For 1942, Capcom turned to Yoshiki Okamoto. We have briefly mentioned Yoshiki Okamoto before. He was responsible for Gyrus and Time Pilot, both published by Konami. Okamoto joined Capcom in 1984 and began work quickly. For this game, Okamoto wanted to bring in an international audience, specifically with the American audience in mind. Okamoto was inspired by World War II, particularly the Battle of Midway. Because the game was designed with the American market in mind, the player plays as an American P-38 fighter plane battling the Japanese. For the music of the game, Capcom turned to Ayako Mori. 1942 was a scrolling shooting game. The player controls a Lockheed P-38 Lightning fighter plane, known as Super Ace, in a loose recreation of the Battle of Midway. The player must destroy the Japanese fighter planes, including Kawasaki Ki-61s, Mitsubishi A6M-0s, and Kawasaki Ki-48s. At the end of levels, the player will encounter a boss, a Nakajima G-10N. The player must shoot the other planes while dodging enemy fire, including by using rolls and a vertical loop. The player can also collect power-ups, including one that allows two smaller planes to join alongside the main plane. Capcom released 1942 to Japanese arcades on November 30th, 1984. Capcom would also release the game to European arcades in May 1985 and North American arcades in July 1985. That is a brief backstory to 1942. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. This is 1942, released in 1984 by Capcom. Hopefully that was not confusing as I introduced the game, but the game's name is a year, and that makes it difficult when I'm talking about years. This is basically the game. You get to play as a fighter pilot. You take on a whole bunch of Japanese fighters. You would obviously be the best World War II fighter ace ever, possibly the best fighter ace of all time, if you were able to kill this many enemies while they were flying and trying to kill you in a war situation. But this is a video game, so hopefully we'll be able to tackle, I don't know, 100? Let's go for 100 enemies. Those red ones, that's what you want to do. You want to take those on. And here's the top 5 ranking score. Capcom, all right, reserved. And then Exodexis. I should be able to make the high score list. I'm not sure about first, but I'll see what I can do in this one. Let's see what I can do. I feel that I'm okay at the game, but we will see. I don't use the vertical thing as much as I should. It does make you completely invulnerable while you're doing it. I should point out that the game does have an auto-fire feature, but it's very slow, so That did not work out well. We're gonna have multiple takes of this. This is auto fire. This is how slow it is. Okay, so I'm just gonna spam here. Wow. And that's it. That's it. You get 3 lives, period. And I only shot down 17. That is the worst that I have done in a long time in this game. I get 11. I don't get my name in there. I don't get my name. All right. Press and hold fire, and then press the start button. Well, I need a coin first. Then I can... All right. Pick up where we last left off. I won't obviously go through all 32 stages, but I will, you know, try to show off what I can. All right, try to get the red ones, because they give you power-ups if you get all of them destroyed. Okay, try to take you on. Okay, and the power-ups do not last between lives. If I die here, I will lose this quad cannon thing. Okay. So far we're doing all right this time. A lot better than the first run. Yeah, that was pitiful. No, I missed it. Fired around it the whole time, but they were coming at me. It makes it difficult when there's too many enemies on the screen. They also don't shoot at me very often. I don't know about you, but if I was in a war like this, I'd probably be spamming attack just like I am now. Alright, down you go. No power-ups for that. Now, I tend to stay at the bottom of the screen, and that's not always the smartest idea, because they can come up from the bottom, too. Alright, here is the end of the stage. Shooting down, I got 83%. And we made it to stage 31. They count backwards. Alright, not so bad so far, but once again, you really need to focus when you start seeing the red ones show up on the screen, because that's how you get the power-ups. And I think the power-up that those would have dropped was an extra life, but I'm not entirely sure about that. I have a bit of practice with this one. There we go. Gotcha. Power is kill everything on the screen. Wish I had known that before I grabbed it. You can tell by the color, but I don't have the colors memorized by any means. All right, he's almost done. He was flashing. That's how you know he's almost gone. Okay. And yeah, I try to focus more on dodging, right? You don't have to kill the enemies, but you do have to dodge their bullets. So that should be your priority of the two. No? All right, gotcha. Don't know what that is. So I'm going to grab it. Kill everything on screen again. I'll take it. Feel like I could save those for better times, but if I don't know what they are... And that kills everything on the screen, yes? Yes. So I saved it until something else showed up, but I probably could have just tackled those guys myself. I do have the high score now, so I'm considering this one a victory. Okay, and got you. Yeah, the power-ups don't last between lives so often when you're playing the game. You know, you get to a point where you die, and then... Now, like, the things that overwhelmed you are probably going to overwhelm you again. I'm not sure what the whistling is. I feel like the music just has a whistle in it. Drums and whistle. The old army theme song. Well, Air Force. All right, we have to... Oh, and down I go, and I think that's it. No, I get another life. Yeah, I don't use the vertical roll too much. I need to use it more, but... You know, I don't honestly think of it until it's, like, too late. Because I'm just used to other... other means of dodging, which is, you know, scooting. Scoot left or right. Okay, what do we got? That's a new color. What does this do for me? Nice. And instant death. I got the ads and then instant death. All right, so I killed 330, which is 83% of what showed up. And I'm in the top 80%, and it gives me the chance to put in my name. So let's go ahead and do that. How much are you gonna let me in here with? Ballersk. And they won't let me do anything more. But I did have to use, what, 3 for that. I think that is good enough. My thumb's starting to get a bit sore from smashing the button a lot, and I'm probably not going to do better than that. So I think that is 1942 played, and with the game played, it's time to talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, I do have to say that I do have fun playing 1942. This is a game that I have played before. It's a game that I probably will play again. It is a fun game. With that said, because of the setup that I have and the fact that the auto fire button doesn't really fire as quickly as I would like, I can only play it for a limited period of time before my thumb starts wearing out. Of course, if you're playing the arcade game, it's a lot easier to tap the arcade cabinet button than it is the way that I have it set up here. So you can go longer than I can in a game like this. I think that this is a good evolution of the shooter genre that we have kind of been exploring to this point. The power-ups are definitely something that I enjoy. There are a few of them, right? Kill all the enemies on the screen, fire 4 bullets, have the side fighters, which I got a chance to use, and I think I fired like 2 fires with it before I lost them, maybe just 1. Extra life, some of the things that we didn't get to see are it'll stop enemies from firing at you for a limited period of time, but only the small planes. You get an extra loop, which I never really used, but that makes you invulnerable, so always useful, and then just flat 1,000 points. Those power-ups, though, I think are an improvement that the genre kind of needs. We need to be able to move the genre in a direction. We need to expand on what we have seen to this point. And I think those power-ups are a good way to do that. And then, of course, having a realistic theme, although kind of an odd one. Not that World War II is odd. I think that is a good choice for a game like this. But it's a little odd that a Japanese company would have Japan as the enemy in the game. But that is a choice that they had made and stuck with, and I don't necessarily mind it. It's just a little odd. Not nearly as odd as some of the other stuff that we have talked about, but odd decision, I would say. But the Battle of Midway is a huge part of World War II, and this helps kind of celebrate that, I guess. And you know, I enjoy the realistic side of it, kind of having realistic looking planes fighting against each other in a fairly realistic way. But of course, like I mentioned before, if you're a fighter pilot in the United States military and you have 330 confirmed kills all in one mission, like, you're like the best of all time easily. Not something that was realistic, really. But it's a video game, so the creative license is allowed there. Ultimately, looking at the game, I think the gameplay holds up very well. I think this is a game that people will still like to sit down and play. If you're a fan of shooters, this is a game you should check out. I think the graphics also hold up very well. I think everything looks like it's supposed to. I think that is definitely one of the highlights, being able to see realistic looking World War II planes. I think that is definitely good. The sound, on the other hand, I don't think held up well. I think that the music is a little grating, not too bad, but I think the longer that you play it, the more you just try to tune it out, because it's just not adding all that much to the game. But Overall, I think the game holds up well. If you are a fan of shooting games, this is definitely one that should be something to check out for you. Definitely, if you see it in an arcade, put in a quarter or two, play as best as you can. The fact that it has a continue option is also a huge deal. That is definitely something worth checking out, even for a modern gamer. And that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, 1942 proved to be popular. For a few weeks, the game would be one of the best-selling arcade games in Japan. The game would also be popular in Europe and North America. Critics at the time also seemed to enjoy the game, particularly enjoying the graphics and gameplay, although some critics found the subject matter odd for a Japanese company. 1942 would see ports, sequels, and re-releases. We will keep an eye on these as we continue. Capcom would use the momentum of their best-selling game to this point to continue making video games. We will hear from Capcom again. As for Yoshiki Okamoto, he would also continue to create video games, and we will hear from Yoshiki Okamoto again in the future as well. That will do it for the story of 1942 for now. My name is Baller Scuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we open things up.